Okay, YouTube. So, carb cycling is a video that I think everyone and their mother has pretty much requested us to make. So, here we are. Welcome to carb cycling. In the next clip, we will actually explain the benefits of carb cycling. I just wanted to give you guys a foundation of what this whole carb cycling thing actually is. That way, you have a frame of reference and you've built a foundation on the idea and the concepts behind it. That way, when we explain the benefits, you'll be like, oh, that does make sense because I already know the things. So, if you haven't watched my previous video on how to spot shady protein bars, it's actually a really good foundation for this video as well, just because I will be going through numbers and how many calories are in fat, how many calories are in protein, how many calories are in carbs, things like that. There will be pretty numbers right here for you guys, your visual learner, it'll be there. That just is a really good foundation. You certainly don't have to watch it. I will explain it here as well, but just so you guys know, it's a really good video anyway, so you should check that out as well. So, what is carb cycling? Carb cycling is a diet in which your calories stay the same. Your calories will always stay the same, and your protein will always stay the same. However, it is a really good way to lose fat without sacrificing your muscle and your strength. And again, we'll explain that in the next clip. However, just wanted to lay this foundation for you guys. It's a diet, and it will help you lose fat. Can you lose fat with other diets? Absolutely. Can you lose fat on not carb cycling? Yes. Can you lose fat on totally keto? Yes. You can lose fat on a ton of different diets. However, this is one that really works well for us. It's really worked well for a lot of our clients. So, carb cycling, diet. The rules. I guess there are no rules, but the principles that you should follow if you are wanting to carb cycle. So, the numbers that I'm going to show you guys are just a visual representation. They're an example. They are not my macros. They are just basic numbers that was easy math for me to figure out to explain to you guys this whole carb cycling idea. So, like I said, your calories will always stay the same and your protein will always stay the same. So, let's take a 1500 calorie example. So if you are eating 1500 calories and that is the perfect caloric intake for you to lose fat, to lose weight, that's your number. So, we're going to pretend that that's your number. So, on a high carb day, so high days, whenever we talk about high or low, that just is in relation to carbs. So, carb cycling, you aren't altering your calories. Like I said, you are just altering the source in which you are getting your energy. So, there's energy in everything that we eat. Some people break down fat easier for energy, and some people break down carbs easier for energy. Some people kind of do both. This will really give you a good idea on which you are, because you will have more energy on the days in which your body can easily break down the macro or the nutrient that you're actually eating. So, a high day means high carb day. So, your calories are 1500. We already established that. Your protein is always going to stay the same. Let's just say you are at 40% protein for your macros, which means if protein has 4 calories per gram, which is explained in my other video, that means 600 of your calories are coming from protein. So, 150 grams of protein in your 1500 calorie diet. That will always stay the same no matter if it's a high, low, medium, schmedium, whatever day it is. Your calories will always stay the same and your protein will always stay the same. So the only thing that changes are your carbs and your fats. The ratios stay the same, it's just the grams that will change and the source of your energy. So let's just again keep going on our high day. So you're at 150 grams of protein and that's 40%. Which means you still have 60% of your calories and your macros to fill between carbs and fats. So if it's a high day, we're going to go high carb. We're going to aim for 55% carbs. Simple math over here will show you that that means you're going to intake 200 grams of carbs, which will equal to about 800 calories. And I'm reading off my little notes just so that I don't mess up this simple math. Which means that 55% of your total calories will be coming from those carbs on high days. The remaining 5% or 11 grams of fat will come obviously from fat. So your remaining 5% of your macros and your calories will come from your fat. So 11 might not seem like a lot. Some people might be like, oh my gosh, that's so low, yada, yada, yada. It just means you need to find carb sources for your diet. So what does this mean? This means oats. This means sweet potatoes. This means quinoa. This means brown rice. This means healthy, slow digesting carbs. You can have fruit. I'm not the biggest advocate for fruit. You can certainly do that. They are higher in carbs as well. And you need to be counting all of your carbs, which means you need to be counting your veggie carbs as well. I know some people say to not do that. This is a total carb count. This isn't net. This isn't carbs minus fiber. This is total carbs. So just keep that in mind. So you see the high day over here. Now let's switch to your low day. So I'm as I said, your calories will stay the same and your fat will stay the same and your ratios will stay the same. So the 55% and the 5% will always stay the same. The only thing that's going to change on a low day is that you're going to have low carbs and high fat. So you're just going to switch those energy sources. So instead of having 200 carbs, you're actually going to have 18 carbs. Again, seems low, but you will be getting your energy from the fat. So if you're doing 18 carbs, that's 5%. We're going to switch the fat from 11 to 92. So you get 92 grams of fat. So what does this mean? This means lots of avocado. This means lots of nuts. You can do nut butters if you want. You can do coconut oil. Good sources of fat. You can add red meat in if you want. Just make sure you're getting a green supplement as well in there. Fats. Good fats. You'll enjoy it. So hope all of that made sense. Just to reiterate, again, calories stay the same. Protein stays the same. Ratios stay the same. Protein in this example is always at 40%, your energy source was always at 55%, and your non-energy source was at 5%. The numbers are going to change for your carbs and your fat, but there's a lot of constants in this. So if you want, you can alter this in MyFitnessPal. So that's what I'm going to show you guys next. Let me just pull this up. So if you're using MyFitnessPal to log your food, this is the only app that I've ever used. So if you use a different one, I'm not sure if you can do this. You probably will be able to, but again, I only know this one. So to edit this in MyFitnessPal, you're going to go to Nutrition, and you're going to click Macros up here. You're then going to actually click this. So on your low days, this is for your, I'm sorry, for your high days for your carbs. So we'll just change our percentages. So our carbs are going to be 55%, protein 40, fat at 5. And obviously the macros are, the calories are different, but at least you have your percentages in there. So don't pay any attention to those, but for example purposes, I will change it for you guys because I'm a visual learner as well. 1500. So there you go. So there's your numbers. A little different than mine. That's okay. You can follow this. You can follow your own calculations, whatever you want to. But just so you guys know, you can edit it in MyFitnessPal. So let's say now you're on a low day. You will change your carbs to 5%. And you'll change your fat up to 55%. You'll save that. And it will edit it for you. There you go. Same numbers.
Hope that all made sense for you guys. I need to now not save this because it's going to confuse me. However, I am starting my carb cycling diet for the last few weeks of the Arnold. It's actually my birthday today, so you won't see this on my birthday. You'll see this a few days later. So I'm not quite sure if I'm going to start my diet today. It might just be a high day because I do want to go enjoy my birthday. So by the time you see this, you will see all the food that I've been eating. You'll also see in the next clip, like I mentioned, the reasoning behind carb cycling, why it works, and if it will work for you. So, an example of, because I know some people will ask, you need to be on your low days for as long as possible. So we recommend doing 3 low days, 1 high, 3 low, 1 high. And you wanna almost pattern your workouts around them. So for me, like on my high carb days, I will lift a bigger muscle group like back or legs. It just really helps me to have more of that carb energy for the bigger muscle groups. You might be totally different. You might find you have better energy on your fat days, so you wanna mix that up. It's just whatever works for you guys. So again, you can also do a medium day. So you just do like a regular macro day, like a 30-30 kind of split, half down the middle, whatever you guys want, but try it out. Definitely let me know what you think about carb cycling. So see you in the next clip.
So as Sarah just explained, carb cycling is just a method of dieting that involves a planned increase and decrease in your carbohydrates. So don't think of it as some crazy, elaborate, secret method that makes you lose fat faster than everything else. Because again, I just want you guys to remember that it is another form of dieting. Carb cycling, when you have scheduled low days, which are under, 30, 40 grams of carbs, it depends on the person, but let's say we'll just use 40 grams as an example. On your low days, you have under 40 grams of carbs, you have high fat content and a lot of protein. What this is gonna do is, from a hormonal perspective, is your actual serotonin levels are gonna drop and leptin levels in your body are also gonna drop. Those are feel-good hormones. Leptin's more about controlling whether you're hungry or not, you should eat, all that fun stuff. So your appetite actually will decrease when you're on low days, which is kind of odd. But what this does is it forces your body to use up its glycogen storages in the muscle and liver. And when that's depleted, then your body's more susceptible to burning fat for energy. Whenever you are on these low days, your body kind of transforms into this fat burning machine and you're going to town. Whenever you get into a high day, now your body has these carbohydrates, which again can be a double-edged sword, because if you do a lot of research with insulin, you'll find out that carbohydrates not only can stimulate molecule absorption into the muscle, but it can also be absorbed into fat, which is where it can get kind of risky. Are carbs bad? Well, this is kind of why the carb cycling side of things can be very effective, because carbs also have very anabolic properties to them that can help you build a lot of muscle. What I like to do is I'll do 2 to 3 days on a low carb diet, and then I'll switch over to a medium or high day. Let's just say high day. And by doing that, you're gonna give yourself a nice little hormone spike, because everyone knows when you start dieting, your mood sours, you get all kinds of these crazy things going on in your body, and you're just like, you just don't wanna do anything, you get all crazy. And I don't know of any other way to say it other than, yeah, you get a little crazy dieting. Well, that's because of all your feel-good hormones in your body are just kind of dropping, you know, because your body doesn't like to be in a calorie deficit. You know, it wants to be in a normal state to where it's happy. Calories in versus calories out are the same or even a little bit more. When you take that away from the body, it wants to fix it. So what's nice about carb cycling and why it can be so effective is because when you have those high carb days, your body actually releases that serotonin, which will make you feel really good. You know, your leptin levels actually will spike, which is also a control center, by the way, for fat burning hormones. So you get a nice little metabolism spike when you have high carb days. So by not strictly going on a ketogenic style of dieting, which is no carbs all the time, by doing this carb cycling approach, you can actually have a spot where you go low carb. You get the benefits of burning up all your glycogen, which again can accelerate fat loss. But then before your body starts tapping into muscle tissue for energy, you bring back the carbohydrates. These carbohydrates then allow you to have those hormonal spikes to give you the added benefit of the mood increasing, your overall energy levels can be increased, and obviously the anabolic effects of storing glycogen into the muscle. Now, that's the part where I want to talk about why carb cycling can be very effective, is because when you are on a low day and your body burns up a lot of glycogen, you're leaving a lot of space for carbs to be stored in the muscle. Where in normal cases on a high carb diet all the time, a lot of the time when your glycogen levels are totally full, your body is then gonna take those carbohydrates that you ate and then put those into fat. It turns the glucose right into fat cells, and that's not gonna be good. So it fills up the fat with glucose, which is not good. By eating carbohydrates after a couple of days of not eating carbohydrates, you now have this excess area that you can then store the carbohydrates in the muscle, which obviously leads to less carbohydrates being stored as fat. So can you have your cake and eat it too? In this situation, yes, but not literally, because you're gonna still wanna eat good carbohydrates. Again, low days can accelerate fat loss. The high days can increase your mood and everything else. The downfall to carb cycling is it is a system that you gotta be very meticulous about, because you can't just plan everything as you go along throughout the day. You know, oh, I better stop and get this. I mean, it is very, very methodical. You've gotta have everything detailed out, everything very well planned, or you could screw up this whole little system of carb cycling. Now, carb cycling isn't for everybody. So keep that in mind. You know, so for example, a lot of people, you know, they're like, well, whenever I carb cycle, actually on my high days, because my metabolism increases so much, I'm starving, I get all these cravings, I'd rather just stay on a low day. Well, your style of dieting may be ketogenic and you may enjoy a keto style of diet. Now, I say that because whenever you are actually on a keto diet, the word keto is just short for your body be able to process ketones as a form of energy. Because don't forget, your brain actually uses a ton of energy throughout the day. It loves glucose. It's actually addicted to carbohydrates and sugars and everything else. It is addicted to it. So going on a keto diet, you basically cleanse your brain of the carbohydrates. And then your brain then uses ketones as a form of energy. Which, when it does, think of your body as a detox. Your brain detoxes from carbohydrates and you'll stop craving them, you know, when you're in a keto style of dieting. It's another form of dieting that may be good for you if carb cycling doesn't necessarily work. Or, you know, if you're just wanting to try something different, try both out and see. But make sure you actually test your urine to see if you're actually in ketosis. And those strips are very inexpensive. You can find those if you're going to get into the keto style of dieting. I want to give you guys some protocols to follow during your carb cycling diet if you choose to do one. You know, number one, you want to make sure your carb cycling diet is high in protein. If you study the thermic effects of food, you will find that protein above fats and carbs burns the most calories in your body in order to be processed and utilized by the body. So have a diet that is high in protein. You know, I personally do about 40% protein in my carb cycling diets. You know what? Is that right? I think it is. It works incredibly well. It works incredibly well for my clients. It does amazing. So again, do you have to do 40%? No. Is there someone else out there that says you need to do 30% or 20%? Sure. Are they right? Probably. Probably not. It's hard to say. Anyway, we do 40 to 45% on our carb cycling diet. Take that up into however many calories you need throughout the day. You know, in order to figure that out, you need to calculate your total daily energy expenditure. Once you figure that number out, then you can figure out how many calories that you need to eat on a daily basis. Then take 40% of those calories, put it into protein, divide the rest up into your carbs and fats. And then you can break it down 2 to 3 low days at a time. High day, medium day, low day, high day. And there's not a set number of low days to high days or high days to low days. Experiment with that. That's kind of the fun part about, you know, dieting is you can experiment a little bit with different types of protocols and see which one works best for you. Let's recap so you really understand carb cycling, what it is, how it works, and is it for you? So what is carb cycling? Carb cycling is a style of dieting where you plan an increase and decrease in carbohydrates throughout the week, where you have scheduled high carbohydrate days, low carbohydrate days, and medium carbohydrate days throughout the whole entire week. And you cycle those days day in and day out. You do a series of low days to high days to medium days. How does carb cycling work? Well, low carb style dietings are very effective. However, being on a low carb diet, typically your serotonin levels will drop, which is a feel good hormone in your body that makes you happy. So if those start dropping in your body, then you're not going to be a happy camper anymore. And you're probably going to be pretty nasty to hang out with. So can low carb diets cause that? Yes, because of the mood souring effects that it has. So what's nice about carb cycling is right when those effects start taking place and your mood starts souring, typically you get a high day, which can increase your serotonin levels, making you very happy, making you a type of person that is tolerable to be around. Now, other hormones that are affected by carbohydrates, obviously, are insulin. Insulin can be very anabolic, which is good for building muscle, but it can also be very good for building fat. So what's nice about carb cycling is whenever you actually go from a low day to a high day, the low day pretty much can wipe out all your glycogen in your muscle, which then leaves the high day to a place to put all the carbohydrates when you're consuming them on your high day. The benefit of that is whenever you actually are consuming all these carbohydrates, a lot less of them are going to be stored as body fat. So you get your high carbs, which everyone enjoys, and you don't get much of a risk of them being stored as body fat. So that's why carb cycling can be very effective from an insulin side of things. Now, leptin level is another hormone that is affected by the consumption of carbohydrates. So whenever you eat high concentrations of carbohydrates, leptin also increases. Now, leptin levels, think of leptin as a control center for fat-burning hormones. So when your leptin levels decrease, your body's desire to burn fat also decreases. This happens when you're in a calorie deficit because it is trying to make fat more and more valuable. This is why scheduled refeed days, cheat days, treat days, whatever you want to call them, are so important whenever you're dieting, is because of this hormone leptin. Because if you just stay in a calorie deficit forever, then your leptin levels will start dropping and you'll burn less and less fat. So what's nice about having a high consumption of carbohydrates, your leptin levels in your body will actually increase, therefore giving you a nice little boost in your metabolism. So by having a scheduled high day, even though the calories are necessarily the same, just because you're going from no carbs to a lot of carbs, you get that leptin level increase without the added calories, which can obviously give you a big benefit when it comes to burning more fat. So outside of that, there's probably a lot of other hormones, but those are the main ones that matter on carb cycling. Now, based on what I just said, it sounds like the carb cycling diet is the best diet in the world, and it's a miracle, and everyone should do it. Well, it's not for everybody. You know, this is getting into that last point. Is carb cycling for everyone? And the answer is no, it is not. Methodical engineering of carb cycling is pretty complex. So you're gonna have scheduled high days, low days, you know, all this stuff, it's all planned out. You have a lot that goes into it. So it makes dieting on the go very, very difficult. It makes being around other people and doing social events very difficult. So whenever you do a carb cycling diet, it's not like you could just go out and pick up something from a restaurant, because quite frankly, they cook a lot of their food in oils. And if you add in too much fat, when you're on a high carb day, you could screw up the whole protocol that you're supposed to follow and then put yourself in a calorie surplus. You know, so it is a very systematic style of dieting that's not really easy to follow, which can burn people out very quickly. You know, but if you're a very scheduled person, if you have the ability to prep all your food very easily and you're home a lot, or your work allows you to eat every couple of hours, then you know what, carb cycling probably would be a good form for you. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this video on carb cycling. You know, I've kept it simple for you. I hope it made a lot of sense. And if you guys do give it a try, comment below, let us know what you guys think of carb cycling. You know, we really appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, go ahead. There's a lot of videos like this that we will be producing. And if you want to learn more about our style of dieting and what we do for our clients, by all means go to bomarfitness.com and check out what we have available there.